Hey guys and girls, welcome to episode 12 of Can It Climb. That's right, we're up to a dozen of these videos, which is great, because this is a series I can see that keeps going and going and going, and I'm hoping you guys are enjoying it. Anyway, this is a user request video. This vehicle was originally going to be scheduled for episode 14, but I've decided to fast track it for Darkside 0914, or 0914, whatever Darkside's name is. But Darkside, I know, is a Volkswagen fan, and this is a request especially for him. We're going to take the BF injection up the Mount Chilliad trail, and you can buy the BF injection if you decide to do so. But as you can see, it comes with a damaged dashboard, a little bit of a rustic paint job. It is based on a Volkswagen Baja bug, which means it is an off-road vehicle. That's why it couldn't be voted for in the series that we just had, which was your choice of the vehicle in episode 10. The reason why this one couldn't be in it is because it is an actual off-road vehicle. So anyway, let's run through what the BF injection is all about. It's a $16,000 Baja bug, pretty much, or beach buggy being the term. It comes in several different colors, super reinforced shocks, perfect for cushioning when you are jumping sand dunes and landing with such ferocity that you might bite your tongue in two. Now, the top speed's actually pretty good. It's 3 and a bit bars. The acceleration is pretty good. It's 3 bars. The braking is 1 bar, and the traction is 3. So let's just walk you through it. Okay, as the sun sets, this is going to probably end up being a nighttime video, so let's get those lights on. Actually, for the time being, we'll turn them off. This is the one that I've managed to find, the BF injection I managed to find. As you can see, it's got some off-road sand paddles on the back wheels, some nice narrow ones for navigating those sand dunes. This one's got a silver and sort of copper paint job to it. As you can see, the engine is exposed at the back. It's basically just an exposed engine, although it doesn't seem to be fussed about rain or anything like that, which is really cool. On the inside, we have pretty much a eaten out rusty dashboard with one dial, a speedo. That's it. We've got an air freshener, some little stylish round windows. The interior is pretty beaten up. As you can see, no room for rear passengers, but we do have a split oval window at the back, which is pretty cool. That'd make it really hard for someone to shoot you from behind. But in saying that though, the side windows are massive. Okay, let's get... Oh, nice steering wheel too. Nice sports steering wheel. But the dashboard has seen better days. Let's get going with the BF injection. Inside first. Now, unfortunately, it doesn't really have that classic Volkswagen noise to the engine. I wish it did, but it doesn't. I'll let you guys hear it for yourself as we make our way up. Acceleration's pretty good, actually. To me, it sounds less Volkswagen and more Subaru. Let's get those lights happening. It feels really good to drive, to be honest. It really does. Now let's bring it up to our flex test and see how we go. There's our two shrubs and up we go. Now this thing rides pretty high from standard. I might not be able to get it to lift a wheel. Oh, there we go. Just lifted a wheel on the back end. That's pretty good. I like that. It's not bad from a Volkswagen Beetle, but anyway, let's take it down. I don't think we're going to have any trouble with departure and approach angles because this thing is pretty short overhangs both front and rear. Look at that, not even a problem. Whew. So yeah, I think this the engine sounds, as I said, more Subaru than Volkswagen. But you guys can be the judge of that. Okay, here comes the pod section. Not a problem. It even went even further forward than I thought it would. The engine actually feels strong. Surprisingly strong. I'm actually having to back off the accelerator. It's pretty cool. Okay, here comes our little lip test that we often do. Let's see how we go with the BF injection. Now, if it wasn't for the fact that I was about to go off the edge, I'm pretty sure this thing could have made it all the way up there. So, I'm going to try again, and this time I'm hoping I don't mess it up for you. Alright, here we go. No problems! One of the first vehicles to take up that lip test and passed, no problems at all. Here we go, the climb to the summit, well at least to the plateau before we hit the summit. So far I'm feeling good about this. Let's go. Well, we're up to the plateau, and I've got to say, this thing is surprising me. You know, I naturally assume Volkswagen Beetles to be underpowered, and, you know, from the ones I've driven, they're actually quite fun. But for me, you know, they're usually with a 1300 or 1600cc engine. I think this thing has got to be at least an 1800cc to pull that kind of stunt. In fact, I would actually believe that this has actually got a Subaru engine in it, because that just hauled up the hill. Really easy. So let's see how it goes. Can it get all the way to the top? We're about to find out. Ha! Not an issue at all. I'm not even going to bother looking at the damage because I know there is none. This thing's an absolute off-road weapon. Unreal. I'd like to really thank Darkside0914 or 0914. I can't remember how you pronounce your username. But I got to thank Darkside for making me push this episode forward, because this has been an absolute joy. It's been a blast. This thing is amazing. Anyway, what we're going to do is take it back down. Back through the gap in the rocks. Not an issue. In fact, I have a feeling this could be one of the first vehicles that actually flies off the mountain on its own. Okay, let's see where we go. Engine braking is not that good. It actually got a little bit of runaway up there. It runs away on you on downhills though, so just watch that, guys and girls. I love the long travel shocks on this thing. It's cool. It makes everything so smooth. We got up it, we can go down it. Beautiful. Well, bit of a spin, but that's all right. Perfectly controlled. I knew what I was doing. No, I didn't. No, I really didn't. Here we go. Off the drop. No problems at all. Little bit of, as I said, the engine braking is not strong with this one. Oh, that took that in its stride. What a blast. And this time I'm not going to mention the train. I'm having too much fun. Even though I just mentioned the train. You guys should know by now, leave the trains alone. Well, here we are, guys and girls. Back to the sawmill. And the BF injection is not even scarred. Not even a dent. What an incredibly fun vehicle to drive. Do I recommend this thing? Heck yes. If you're lucky enough to find one in the game, grab one. Other than that, take it to Los Santos Customs. Put your own rims and tires and paint and engine work and gearbox work. And just have an absolute blast like I just did. And guess what? Because it is completely unscathed, it moves through to the final test. The Canis Seminole was also, I believe, the only other vehicle to come down that mountain unscathed. And it also gets subject to the final test. That's the logs. Ready? Here we go. What logs? What logs? In fact, I'm so confident in this vehicle, I think we'll do it from this way. Might be biting off a bit more than it can chew, because that's a big log. But let's see how we go. Oh, not enough speed. Let's try again. Give it the berries. Oh, well. That's okay. This thing has thoroughly passed the test. It went up and over the logs. It's done really, really well. I have had an absolute blast bringing this video to you guys and girls. I hope you enjoyed it just as much as I did. And as I said, thanks to Darkside0914 for suggesting the BF injection. But it was originally going to be episode 14, but I've decided to bring it forward to episode 12, and I really am glad I did. This thing is an absolute blast. Until next time, guys and girls, I'm going to say bye for now. And don't forget, get your comments down below for the muscle car challenge, which will be coming up in episode 15. Make sure you vote down below. If you don't know what muscle cars are available in Grand Theft Auto 5, jump on the Grand Theft Auto wiki. Make sure it's a muscle car that I can get off the streets. So Vapid Dominator, Gauntlet, Tornado, Buccaneer, they're just a few that I can think of off the top of my head. you know, there are a few more. I just can't think of what they are. But anyway, guys and girls, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and, of course, share. And I will catch you guys next time in episode 13. Bye for now.